A special series of stories we have been building up to now for weeks. They are this year's Jefferson Award honorees.
Process actually began weeks ago with dozens of nominations that we got from you, our viewers, all to honor people for their outstanding work as community volunteers. And in February, judges from KSBW, along with First Capital Bank, selected this year's six finalists.
And this week here on Action News, we will introduce you to all six of this year's honorees. Two each night over the next three nights. And we begin with Alicia Allen of Monterey and Edith Ichiuji of Pacific Grove.
So it needs to be fixed. It needs to be waxed. And get ready to go for the next weekend.
Sergeant Alicia Allen is in almost constant motion. Her motion dedicated to serving others. Her job as a sergeant at the U.S. Army. A commitment to serving her country. After getting a master's degree in public administration, she joined the Army and turned 30 during basic training. Unconventional? Well, that's Sergeant Allen.
I really had a desire to serve, and I couldn't shake it. So I thought, well, you know, I just want to do this before I get too old. And it's really been a joy in the journey. You know, it's not easy every day, but what is?
So after a couple trips, we use the grinder.
Nothing has been easy for Alicia Allen, but she doesn't complain. In fact, she relishes a challenge. Here, she's organizing and prepping dozens of sets of skis and snowboards so soldiers can get an economical trip to the Sierra. Looking at her, you might not know that she's got two tours of Iraq under her belt, and she is an inspiration to others, just pulling into the parking lot for work. Others like Jordan Booker.
What struck me, though, is one day I was coming to the parking lot, and she had pulled up, and she had her car full of recyclables. Full.
Alicia hauls a lot of things around. She drives soldiers home on weekends, drives the bus for countless events, and seems to drive empty cans everywhere so the recyclables can be cashed in.
What the company does is they take that money and they pay for the soldiers' tickets to the Army Ball, because a lot of the privates don't have enough money to buy the tickets. And it's on a sliding scale, so the tickets aren't as much for the privates as they are for the officers and things like that. But what we've been able to do is pay for every single ticket for all the privates in our company.
Short Special Olympics, the ASPCA here, recycling program, Alzheimer's disease. She, over Thanksgiving and Christmas, I know she went and fed the homeless, soup kitchens and things like that. So that really is what inspired, she has inspired me to do more, to want to do more.
They gave me training at the beginning of the season so I would be able to set the skis.
Sergeant Alicia Allen is an inspiration, but for her, it's just what she does.
You know, no one, I don't think anybody thinks that, you know, they're really making a difference or something. I just kind of, you know, was out there doing my thing.
And her thing inspires others to find their thing. And do it for the community, too.
Yeah, and it's a great catalyst for other people. Yeah. So, you know what? Look what she does. I want to do that, too.
Service to others and service to country. That is Sergeant Alicia Allen.
Thank you for the food that thou hast provided.
This is a remarkable lady.
The Salvation Army's truck brings comfort to those struggling. They call it the Hope Mobile. Today it's in Monterey, and working out of that truck, offering any help she can, is Edith Ichiuji.
For those who didn't sign in, I'm just checking them in.
Edith's dedication to the Salvation Army is somewhat legendary, as is her commitment to helping others.
She's served the underserved and underrepresented for many years. She's been on the Salvation Army board, ringing the bell, feeding the homeless, as well as giving time and money to the agency.
To me, it's, you know, not for my satisfaction for myself, but what I can do for the other people and getting to know them.
If it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't be where I am now, doing so well.
Well, I'm glad to see you back again.
You may not think that Edith would have all the struggling with alcoholism, depression, and homelessness, But her real gift bonds them, listening.
In a desperate situation, she always has time enough to talk to somebody and to help them come through that. So for that, I'm really grateful to her. And she's brought me through a couple of heavy times that I've been through. And I think without her guidance and the guidance of a few others, I probably wouldn't be as healthy and happy as I am right now.
And these guys get all the extras and the leftovers, and they bring them here, and to us, it's the top of the world.
Behind her guidance, a lifetime of experience and wisdom. A nurse by training, she was in a Japanese internment camp in World War II. She became a mother of three. Decades of church service behind her and work with so many community groups, we couldn't list them all. But now, it's with the Salvation Army where she has the biggest impact, and they'd be hard-pressed to do much without her.
She's in her late 80s, has many physical ailments, and she just overcomes them to go out twice a week to feed the homeless, rain or shine, and do all these other services.
The Lord is good here. I've been to church with Edith.
And Edith does it all with a humble heart, a humble heart that helps change lives.
I hope that I'm able to continue to do what I can for others.
We will introduce you to another pair of this year's Jefferson Award honorees tomorrow morning on Action News Sunrise and right here on Action News at 6 o'clock as well.
And you can learn more about the program and our honorees anytime at KSBW.com.